In the context of climate change, the refrigeration and air conditioning sector, RAC for short, plays a crucial role. The demand is increasing steadily due to urbanization, economic development, and global warming itself. At the same time, the cooling sector is a major contributor to global environmental and climate-related problems. Direct and indirect emissions can occur at various stages of a cooling device's life cycle, from production and use to disposal. The negative effects of synthetic refrigerants are wide-ranging. Besides the heavy energy consumption during production, they use up finite natural resources like fluorine and chlorine. Ozone-depleting substances, ODS for short, have high ozone depletion potentials and very high global warming potentials. HFCs are used as substitutes for ODS, but have very high global warming potentials as well. Other synthetic refrigerant alternatives like HFOs were found to have persistent toxic breakdown products that can, for example, end up in the groundwater. Blends of these refrigerants are often difficult to recycle. At the end of a product's life cycle, they remain as toxic waste, and their proper disposal is a challenge. If we are to achieve the global sustainable development goals, the cooling sector needs to change significantly. We need sustainable architecture and urban planning adapted to higher temperatures. Where the use of RAC systems cannot be avoided, the concept of green cooling offers a solution. Green cooling refers to the use of natural refrigerants and foam blowing agents in combination with highly energy efficient equipment and preferably renewable energy sources. Natural refrigerants have many advantages over synthetic ones. For example, they do not deplete the ozone layer and have a very low global warming potential and do not cause persistent toxic waste. While being very energy efficient when used in RAC appliances, they need far less energy during production and use no finite natural resources. In addition, the substances themselves are not tied to any patents. The green cooling approach also significantly contributes to a number of SDGs. For example, modern reliable cold chains prevent food spoilage and vaccine loss. Natural refrigerants and energy-efficient systems protect the climate. The GIZ Proclima program supports partner countries in the transition to green cooling, offering policy advice, capacity building, and technology transfer. Green cooling, the most future-friendly approach for the global RAC sector, with major economic and social co-benefits.